I think the number one complaint that I've heard about Corsair's iCUE software is that it's not very user-friendly, or that it's too complicated. Personally, I don't feel it's that complicated at all, but there is a lot of different options, which can be a bit overwhelming at first. Getting familiar with iCUE does take some time, but once you learn how it works, there's almost no limit to the amount of customization you can make to your RGB peripherals. Anyway, in March of 2021, in an effort to make the interface more user-friendly, Corsair released their latest version of iCUE, that being version 4. Whether or not they've succeeded in making things easier or more user-friendly is going to be a matter of opinion. But for those looking for a tutorial on how to navigate iCUE 4, let's jump on in. Now, this tutorial is not an in-depth breakdown of every single option available in iCUE. This is more meant to be an overview to get you familiar with how iCUE works, so you can get started customizing the lighting on your peripherals and give you the background you need to begin playing around with things and figuring things out on your own. When you first start up iCUE 4, you're going to see the home screen here. It'll have all your iCUE compatible peripherals listed here, and as you can see, I have an Asus motherboard which has lighting on it that is iCUE controllable, a Corsair Night Sword mouse, and a Strafe RGB keyboard. On the left is our current lighting profile. This is one I made that has all the keys illuminated in blue, and then when I type whatever key I press, that key lights up in white and then fades back to blue. Below the profile dropdown is what Corsair is now calling Scenes. In version 3, they called it the Lighting Link. Scenes allow you to instantly change the lighting on all of your devices at once. For example, I can click on Rainbow Wave here, and now that lighting scheme is applied to my motherboard, mouse, and keyboard all at once. Corsair has 6 default scenes included when you download iCUE, but you can press this plus sign and add in some other preset scenes, or even create some of your own custom scenes. Just for fun, let's create a custom one. Here where it says Spiral Rainbow, we have a drop-down we can click on, and it gives us 11 different effects we can choose from. Just as an example, let's choose Rain. Already, our peripherals should be displaying this effect. To honor the late great artist, formerly known as Prince, let's change the scene name to Purple Rain. Now, we've got these 2 circles because we can choose 2 different colors for our raindrops. Let's first click on the red circle here and find a nice shade of purple on our color bar down here. In the bar below that, we can make it lighter or darker. And once we've got a color we like, we can then click on the blue circle. And this time I want a magenta. The purple and the magenta look too much alike. I guess I'll go back to blue. That actually looks more like the effect I was going for. Once you've got your colors dialed in the way you like them, we can adjust the speed, which this slider is a little deceiving because you really only have 3 speeds: slow, medium, and fast. Once we're all done, we can click Create, and now we have a Purple Rain scene we can quickly and easily apply to our peripherals. When you have one of these scenes activated, it's going to override whatever profile is showing here at the top. To deactivate a scene, you just click on that scene's name, and iCUE will then switch back to whatever lighting profile you have selected here. When you're first starting out, you'll of course only have the default profile, so you're going to have to create one of your own. When I upgraded my iCUE 3 to iCUE 4, it kind of brought my old profiles in, and what I mean by that is it brought the names of those profiles in, but all the custom lighting and actions I'd programmed in iCUE 3 did not transfer over, so I had to recreate them in iCUE 4. It took me 10 or so minutes of playing around to figure things out, but being familiar with how iCUE worked before, it didn't take long to get my blue with white type lighting custom profile recreated. Now I want to recreate my red with white type lighting profile, so I'll show you guys how to do that. Mine's already here and named for me to get started on, but since you'll be starting new, you'll first want to press the big plus sign button here, and then choose your profile icon. You can select from these predefined icons here, or click the paint bucket and select a color, or you can click this plus sign and add an image that you have saved on your computer or somewhere. For now, I'm happy to just use this red icon here. You'll then want to give your profile a name. I'm going to be working on my red with white type lighting profile, so I'm going to switch over to that real quick. And if you want to add a background image or even a video clip to the iCUE window, you can select that here and choose whether you want to add some blur to it or not. And finally, you can link an app to your profile. So for example, if you want to have specific lighting or keybinds of some kind for a particular game, you can link that profile to that game. So when you launch that game, iCUE will automatically change to that profile and you'll be ready to rock. Well, once you're all done here, you can click OK. And now we are ready to begin customizing all of our peripherals. I'm going to start with my motherboard first. So I'm going to click on the Asus motherboard icon here. And on the left, click lighting effects. To add an effect, click on the plus sign, and here's all the predefined effects you can apply. If you're just wanting a solid color, which is what I want, you'll need to scroll down to where it says custom here, click on that, and it will bring up all of the choices under that category. I want to start with a red background, so I'm going to first choose static color, and then I'm going to click on this circle over here, and can either click on the color wheel on a red that I like, or I can go down to the bottom here and put in 255 in the red field, and then 0 in green and 0 in blue. You can also click on these four little dots here at the top, and there's default colors you can choose from, but I was kind of disappointed to find they're all pastel colors, and I wanted a red red, not pastel red. So what I did was type in 255 00 here at the bottom, and then hit this plus sign, which added red as one of my custom colors. I'm now going to close this little chooser window, and you can adjust the opacity with this slider here if you want, but I want the lighting intensity at 100%, so I'm just going to leave that alone. These buttons here let me choose the different areas on my motherboard I want this lighting effect to apply to. I don't have anything plugged into my motherboard RGB headers, so I'm just going to select the back IO and PCH, which are the lights here and here. Next, I want a white ripple animation to play over top of my red background. So I'm going to add another lighting layer, and this time from the custom list, choose ripple. It defaults to white, which is what I want, so I don't have to worry about changing the color, but I do want to adjust these options because I feel like the effect is playing too fast. So I'm going to change the lighting time to 3 seconds and the velocity to 5. And I've already played around with this, and I like the way a tail of 3 lights looks the most, so I'm going to change that to 3 as well. Now you'll notice that the ripple effect is first on the list here, above my static red color. If I were to move the ripple layer below the red static color layer, then my ripple can't be seen because it's being covered up by the solid red layer. Think of these effects like layers of paper. If there's an effect you want to see on top of another one, then that effect layer needs to be above the other effect layer in this list. As for my ripple effect, I only want it to play on the back I/O of my motherboard, so I'm going to turn it off on the PCH and RGB headers. There we go, here's how things are looking now. Now let's switch on over to my mouse. We're first going to click on lighting effects here on the left, add a lighting layer, and once again, I want the lights on my mouse to all be solid red. So I'm going to select custom, static color, and then change the color here to red. In the quick lighting zone field here, you can turn the different lighting zones on the mouse on and off. But for what I want, I'm going to select all. Now on top of this, I want to add a little effect where the front and scroll wheel zones on my mouse light up in white when I click a button on my mouse. So I'm going to add a new layer on top of my red layer. And once again, I'm going to go to custom, and instead of static color, I'm going to choose solid, because even though they sound pretty much like the same thing, there is a difference, and static won't let me do what I want to do, whereas solid does. For this effect, I want the front and scroll zones to light up, so I'm going to select those, and to add my solid color, I'm going to then click on this plus sign here. I can change the color by clicking on the circle here and then choosing the color I want, like we've done before, but I want white, so I'm going to leave it white and come back to here. Now we're going to play with the start and stop dropdowns, which are not available to us with a static color. Depending on what you're doing, you can change the lighting time here to make it longer or shorter, but for what I want to do, 1 second works just fine. With profile means it will start playing this effect when your profile is enabled. But what I want is for this to play when I press a button on my mouse. So I need to choose on key pressed instead. In the stop dropdown, we have several different options available to us. There's after, which allows you to have the effect play a certain number of times before stopping. There's on key press, which will turn the effect on and off, kind of like a light switch. On key release, which means the effect will play when you press a button, but then turn off when you release that button. And finally, never, which means once you've pressed a button and that effect plays, it stays on until you restart your PC. I want it to stop as soon as I release the button, so I'm going to choose on key release. So now every time I click my mouse, the front and scroll wheel zones will flash white. Now for the part that most of you watching this are probably going to skip ahead to, let's take a look at the keyboard. If you've been watching up to this point, things should look very familiar because all our options are very similar to what we've already been doing. Let's choose lighting effects here on the left. Add a layer, and once again, there's all the presets we can play with, but I want my keyboard to be red, so I'm going to go to custom once again and choose static color. All the keys on the keyboard are selected for me by default, so I don't need to do anything there, but I am going to change the color to red. The next thing I want to do is change the Corsair logo, the W, A, S, and D keys, and the arrow keys to white. So I need to create another layer and choose static color again. And since it defaults to white, I don't need to change anything here. So I can then choose the stuff I want to be made white. You can use the quick lighting zone buttons here for WASD and the arrow keys. But now to add the Corsair logo, I'm going to need to hold the control key on my keyboard and then click on the Corsair logo here. If I just click on the logo, then it will select only the logo, and WASD and the arrows will no longer light up white. Another way to select the keys and stuff you want to apply an effect to is to hold control and then click on the keys you want to apply that effect to here in iCUE, just like so. Or you can even click and drag to select multiple keys at once. Okay, we are just about done, but there's one more effect I want to add, which is the type lighting. That means whatever keys I type on will light up, just like I showed at the beginning of the video. As you know from the name of my profile, I'm going to make the type lighting white. So I'm first going to add another new layer, go to custom, and choose gradient this time. I want this to play on all keys when they're pressed. So I'm going to leave all selected here, and then I'm going to hit this plus sign. Now with a gradient, you can have it play one color at first and then fade to another, as well as add multiple different colors and adjust the opacity of each individual color. I'm going to keep things simple for this because that's what I want, so I'm going to keep it white. The way I want my type lighting to work is when I press a key, I want it to light up white and then fade back to red. So to make that happen, I need to keep it at 100% here at the beginning of the effect, but then fade all the way to 0% at the end. Now I want it to fade slower than it is right now, so I need to add some time, and I found 3 seconds feels about right to me. As you can see right now, my entire keyboard is pulsing, and I just want this to play on a single key when I press that key. So in the start dropdown, I'm going to change this to on key pressed, which then enables a toggle switch here for it to only play on the key you press. I want to turn that option on. And then in the stop dropdown, I want it to stop playing the effect after it plays through one time. So I'm going to choose after, and it defaults to one time. With all of the customization now done, here's what it's looking like now when I type on my keyboard. Well, I had hoped to keep this video short and sweet, but it's already running longer than I was planning. Hopefully it's given you a good look at how iCUE 4 works and given you the confidence to start playing around and creating your own custom lighting profiles. Thanks so much for watching. There's the YouTube stuff you can do that really helps me out. And if you'd like to help me continue making helpful videos like this one, please check out my Amazon store linked in the video description, where you can purchase products I feature on my channel, including the mouse I used in this video, the Corsair Nightsword, and the Strafe keyboard I used. For the whole two of you still left watching at this point, I want to say thanks so very much for watching all the way until the end. You guys are the best, and I hope to see you in another video real soon. We'll see you later.